Hello, welcome to RuneScape Steam Edition. So what's new? Well, nothing. It's basically you starting RuneScape through Steam. So that's the only change the version of this game has. So there might be some other updates I don't know about, but it's basically you linking your RuneScape account to your Steam RuneScape account and playing on Steam. Which is something the game really needed, but to be honest, this is not a good game in 2020 because, well, it has the subscription-based model, so you need to pay 10 euros every month, otherwise your game is restricted to about 5% of the game. So play for free 5% of the game, play with a subscription of 10 euros per month, play with 95% of the world, and also a lot more perks and benefits because you can unlock your skills. So to be honest, if you want to play without paying the game, it's rubbish, it's trash and it's not worth it. But if you want to play for a long time and you can also make enough money to buy some subscription with in-game money, well, I guess that will be okay. But just remember that you'll need to play about 20 days to make enough money to pay the subscription. In a way it's like if, but it's not like if, because like I say, you'll be restricted to the tutorial area, you'll have certain skills blocked, and you'll have certain possibilities locked to you. So yeah, I haven't logged in 1,600 days. That's, well, a year has 360 days, so that's more than 5 years. Player info, World 19. So it's based on the world. As you can see, the worlds have a number of players on them. So World 1 has 244 players. So if you want to play on a server that is good for you, you just have to see a few things over here. The servers for free-to-play players are very, very limited. Almost, yeah. Man, they really took out the server. So if you want to play, looks like it's basically America and United Kingdom in a way. If you want to play on the free-to-play server, like I said, you'll have a lower population than the member servers only, so you are very restricted. This game should not be free-to-play because it's not free-to-play, it's basically free to see 5% of the game. Well, you got the idea by now, so you select the world. This is a world for trading, so it has a lot more people, but all of them are trading over here. So let's see the best ping for me. I have a 0 ping world. Is that even possible? Looks like it's possible, but I suspect there is something other than that over there. And there are also activity based, so as you can see, Legacy, which I think is the old school landscape. Duel Arena, Friend is still in creation, and a lot of events are, of course, for only members. And yeah. Let's also see the highest player numbers. 1,000 in trading, of course. So the population of the game has slowly declined. At this point, I would say it's not even worth it for you to play. But it's on Steam and I wanted to see how it is. And I want to see also my old character. So let's see my old character. I think I played about 1,000 hours of RuneScape. I don't even remember if this is my original account or if it's my second one. Oh no, it's my second account, it's not my original one. On my original one I had so much stuff on him. Yeah, this one is only 300 hours of playtime or something like that, nothing crazy. That's the amount of time you have to invest in the game to play it. So let's see, no friends. Okay, so many good memories. Like I said, the game is great. Open Steam Valve? What do you mean open Steam Valve? 5,000 coins? Well, that's a lot of coins I just got over here. Let's rob the lamp. So funny. Mining experience, sure. So the graphics have been continually improving in the game and actually redid the whole game as it is. Whatever, so the game is basically pay to play and pay to win, if you're wondering. So it's not free to play, pay to pay, pay to play, pay to win. Some people, like I said, you can use your in-game money to do a lot of stuff, but to get that amount of money, it's so much. Ah, yes, I don't know what the key tokens are. So what's this inspect? RuneScape Steam launch period. Okay. Well, I guess this is a nice thing to have. Ice Warrior boots and 200 steel sword plus one. As you can see, it has a lot of information. Wow, the resolution is kind of bad. And I can't really change... it's missing some features, okay. From the launcher, at least that's how I remember it. I'm pressing the keyboard to change the camera angles, but apparently it's not working. Anyway, it has a lot of chats because you'll need them. Public chat is on. Yeah, the graphics are kind of like 2010. But it's a great MMO if you want to waste a lot of time and also get a lot of money. So let's see. I want to see the map. What's the button for the map? Oh, no. Looks like we have to use the mouse a lot, and that's not really something I'm looking forward to. Also, some of the songs will unlock for you if you complete certain areas. Which is one of the many, many features that players love. Okay, play the song, please. Doesn't work. Well, weird. Too bad we can't listen to that music, because that's some of the best in the game. Oh, they really improve stuff from here. So even this music player has gone through a lot of changes, and you can enjoy a lot of music from the game. And you also have to unlock most of it. And of course, it's mostly for members. Sorry for doing that so much. Animations over here. I'll not show a lot of the game because many of you saw the game. So it's basically a farming game. Farming simulator. For example, you have to, let's say, attack rabbits or other animals 1 million times to get experience points. Or for example, you have to cut down trees 1 million times to get one level. Well, that's high level. In the beginning, you can do so many things to get a lot of experience that it's a bit too easy. So for example, you have raw rabbit. You can cook the raw rabbit to have food. You can also bury the bones of bigger enemies. So it's a very good game in a way. Also, you have your prayer skills, which are... When you bury the bones and do some other stuff, you will have skills that you can unlock. Like increasing your stats or making... keep on extra item if you die. Melee attack rating and so on. It's a very complex system, to be honest. I almost forgot about it. So we have some quests we solved. And these are my skills, so let's see. What did I have here? Mining of 55. Well, that's actually pretty good. Level 55. It shows like that because you can improve your items or your skills with certain potions, drinks and some other stuff. That's actually kind of high level. So I think the max was... Let's actually see the skill guide. The max for mining is 99, if I remember. Oh, 120. Well, yeah. So the more you go into the skill tree, the harder it will be for you to get stuff. For example, in the beginning you can mine copper and tin, and later on you can get to use a better pickaxe, like let's say the steel one. Steel pickaxe, which is at level 20, and then you can mine other types of ore. But to be honest, it's all based on how much you play, and if you play with the membership or the monthly subscription. At level 30 you can mine Mithril Oren, somewhere along the line you'll be able to mine a lot of great stuff, but it's mostly locked behind the membership. See? Members only. So, when I used to play the game in the beginning, you could go up to level 99 and still unlock some of these things, but I think they may... Maybe I'm just... I don't know what I'm talking about. But the game is a good experience if you want to pay for it, and that's kind of it. Magic, strength, attack. Eh, so many cool memories of the game, but like I said, it's not really going to have a lot of people. It's not going to have a big player base. And let's see. Member world? Member world? Member? Member? Member, wilderness is where you can die and lose all your gear. This is the first hardcore PvP that was ever introduced in the game, and I love it for that. Is there a bank over here? Yeah, let's actually go to the bank and let's see how much money I have in the bank. And then I'll end the video maybe. How do you move the camera? Why is it so hard? So controls over here. Move camera. Oh, it's up arrow. Legacy. Why am I in legacy mode? I have to change this. Very weird. I'm pressing the keyboard, but nothing is happening. Anyway, must be some kind of a bug. Okay, if I use the keyboard, it works. Whoa. Very low FPS. I can't enter that room. Okay, that's funny. Well, where is that bank? I want to show you my inventory in the bank. Okay, let's go over there or else. You can also teleport back home and do a lot of stuff, but to be honest, it's not going to work that well. I just wanted to do this video for nostalgia and to warn other people that this is not a game you knew and loved. This is something different, something that... Are those clothes? That's some basic attacks. This is basically a new type of game, which is, to be honest, doesn't really have a room in the current generation. It's too old to be fun now, and it's also too new to be fun to the older people that played it in the beginning. Man, it's so clunky. but still, it would have been better if they just, you know, upgraded the game as it was and made all the features available for all the player in an area. Oh, the water graphics look much better when I played it, because you can... I think they disabled the graphics, the original graphics, but they were so bad. So, we are going to the bank. Why? I'm still surprised there is no music. It should play. I guess it doesn't work on Steam for now, but kind of disappointed that that is not working. Is that the bank? Come on. Climb down the steps. Oh, finally we can go and see my bank. So, where is all my money? I want to see how much money I have. Okay, this is how much money I have. 600,000. And there are people who have millions on top of millions and runes and all of this stuff. It's a very, very complex game. Although people will have the patience to start it again now. What is that in my inventory? What's the small protein pack? Oh, I can buy stuff for that. So, what is this? It's kind of like a pay to win currency. I have no idea. It might be. I don't know what that is. Very weird. And bank the banker. Yeah, sorry I didn't show you much, but I just really wanted to get back to the game. It's sadly going to need a lot of work. I don't know how it will be in the future, but for now I really recommend you just play for nostalgia's sake. But see you next time. Bye.